and then elements of the muscle up and how we can improve that. Okay, so firstly, Chris is going to demonstrate for us a muscle up. So there's certain points of this muscle up I want to cover, i.e. positions in the kip, but it's very hard for me to get Chris to hold these positions on a set of rings. So actually I'm going to start on the board, go through a couple of positions with you guys, and then we'll take it back to Chris, and we'll go from there.
I can just zoom.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
Oh. Okay. Can you see the board?
Yeah. Okay. It's a good camera, man.
Okay, so as by my lovely illustrations here, I'll clear them up so you can understand exactly what I'm talking about. But basically, this one here is what I'm going to talk about first. Imagine we've got a set of rings here, and this is Chris, he's holding onto the rings, that's his head, and his body is hanging back with those rings. He's in his kid position here, hanging off those rings. Now notice we've got this nice curve in Chris's body. He's remained tight the whole way through this, so he's got a nice bit of tension here all the way through his posterior chain. What Chris isn't demonstrating, what we normally see, is this guy here. So he's got the rings, he's hanging onto the rings, his head is there, his body has come back, his legs, his thighs are pretty much in line with his body, and he's pulled his heels up. This is not an effective kick position, and it's one where people try and overcompensate by kicking through their legs and generating no drive from their hip. Whereas if we remain in this nice tight position here, Chris can keep his tight position, and as he pulls through, he still remains in this nice hollow position. And he's going to maintain that all the way through until we reach the point on the rings where the rings are here and he is under the rings as one unit. This is very important, this position. We need to make sure we keep this position. Now, if Chris does this wrong, what we'd see and what we generally see in 99.9% of everyone that attempts a muscle up is this position here. We're under the rings. Our body is down. Oh, hang on, where are we? Rolling?
Rolling, where was
rolling? Okay, so what we want to see is this nice tight position to pull up to the rings. What we don't want to see, and what we see in 99.9% of everyone that sets a muscle up in this gym, is this position here. They're still, all their body weight is still below these rings. So now, the position we've achieved is this. And we've got this break here, where the knee breaks, and we're under the rings, and all our body weight is underneath this ring. So now, I've got all this body weight to pull up and through the rings. Whereas if I'm up level with my rings, my body weight is all up here, right by the ring, and I've just got to pull my torso through to get into that turnover. And all I do in that position is initiate a drive through my shoulders, and then pull through into the top of my muscle up. What a lot of people try and do is throw their hip up to the rings, and you see, you hear the cue, hip to rings quite a lot. That's a terrible cue, because what that implies is throw your hip up. But if I now throw my hip up, something's got to give, and my heels generally come down. So if we now bring it back around to the rings, we'll see both variations of this with Chris. We just come side on, so we can see this. Yeah. So what we now see with Chris, Chris is first going to demonstrate for us the muscle up where the guy breaks as he brings his, as he comes back in his kick, and he also throws his feet through and breaks as he tries to pull up to those rings. Just do two reps for us, please, if you can. So notice in the back swing, we pull the hip back and we drive those heels at hip up and your heels stay back down, and actually that's pretty good. I'm happy that he failed that rep, because it just demonstrates how tough this is. God damn.
Rolling.
Okay, so what Chris is going to demonstrate for us first is the poor muscle up. The muscle up where he's underneath those rings and he actually breaks in the knee on the way back, and we'll notice the position is he's pretty much directly under those rings. Also then initiates by kicking through, bring his knees in front, and also his hip will be below the ring still in both positions. So just demonstrate that for 1 to 2 reps, please. So as he comes through, he drives his knees back, his knees stay in front, and now he catches really deep in the top of those rings, okay? I'm not going to ask you to attempt another rep, because that's ugly as hell, but that is what we generally see from people's first muscle up, okay? What we'd like to see is Chris to keep a nice straight body, okay? Keeping tension in that posterior chain, keeping that nice hollow position. So now we're actually engaged the whole time, and we pull through as one unit, and when he gets to those rings, you'll notice he's still in that hollow position. Also, when he pulls through the rings, I want Chris just to hold as he pulls through the rings, because we're going to notice he maintains that hollow position all the way through, even in the pull through, okay? In the turnover, sorry. So let's go, Chris. So keep him nice and tight in the backswing. And now as he pulls through, we've still got this lovely hollow position. He's going to press out to full extension, and then he's still going in this hollow position, just do one more rep for us. As he comes through, he repeats that hollow position. And you should keep that the whole time and press out and come down from there. And that is a lovely muscle up. Good.